Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Travels with Charlie in Search of America book by John Steinbeck. What great writing, what great adventure. Steinbeck was able to see so much in so little. Steinbeck is of course one of the great American writers, but this book gives the reader insight into the personality of the author. Thoroughly enjoyed reading Steinbeck's journey with Charlie, his dog, full of insight about being human. The addition of Charlie to the account adds an interesting dimension, and changes his interactions with locals along the way. The author is honest about the downside of travel, and his own mistaken notions about areas of the country before visiting. One of those books that lets you turn the world off, and just kick back, and enjoy the trip. He delights in explaining the intricate features of the camper, running water, stove, bedding, and water tank. He was an attraction, the icebreaker that brought many of the characters Steinbeck writes about to life. A journey from New York through New England, then across the top half of the country, then back home by way of the South, gave a nuanced understanding of the feelings about race from the human experience versus the moral and political. It's funny how Steinbeck's comments about places Americans might fit today just as well as they fit in the 60s. Pure Steinbeck at his best, with his careful and thoughtful analysis of what America looked like at the time of the writing of the book. It was wonderful to read it with 2014 eyes, and the book says as much about 1970s America as it does about Steinbeck and his journey across the country with his beloved poodle, Charlie. A great road story with very insightful commentary of America in 1960, including the racial ugliness, environmental concerns, and political unrest. If this projected journey should prove too much, then it was time to go anyway. Travels with Charlie is a very different type of book for Steinbeck, with anecdotes and opinions sprinkled throughout. Wrapped up far too quickly, but long trips like that tend to go that way. It's an excellent read, even if you have never read Steinbeck before, and very humorous and entertaining. Well written, no surprise look at flyover country, and it has a Percival dog significantly throughout. It was a wonderful trip to go on as John Steinbeck traveled around the US-9. Writing in a period that was defined by the turmoil that attended racial integration, Steinbeck captures the character of the era well. Besides being enjoyable as a travel book, the work captures a snapshot of one of the most significant changes that occurred in the period it was written. The content of the book is one of Steinbeck's best laid works in trying to recapture the flavor of the various sections of the United States during the 60s. Excellent read, and the usage of his standard poodle as traveling companion was very amusing. At the time, the critics mostly panned it, but the Cold War, Camelot, and civil rights struggle were then very real, and not yet history. Steinbeck captured the essence of what America was in the late 50s and early 60s in a profound way. This book is such a great look into an America gone by, told in a way that only Steinbeck could do it. Yes, there are questions about how much is fact and how much is fiction, but who cares? The difference in the writing style and the language used by the author compared to the verbal dreck that most authors get away with today is very evident. He found that there is no way to really describe our country in a specific way because of how vast and different each region of the country is. Always with a hand in the pocket, feeling for the trigger of the mace bottle or the noisemaker until each stranger passes our wary inspection. This reader purchased several of this book recently, having in mind to gift them come winter season. No way to overdo it reading any Steinbeck book about anything, person, people, or pet animal any subject. Rather than a novel, this is an autobiographical account of the road trip that Steinbeck took with his dog, and it provides a snapshot of America at the time. He enjoyed the book, and a trip of several miles with Maya, the Jack Russell. The uniformity of food, which, of course, totally changes with the influx of non-Western immigrants from the mid-60s onwards. It was an account of a trip taken in 1960 across America, alone with only his dog for company. Now, some people are saying that parts of it are a work of fiction by Steinbeck. Highly recommend for any high school student who wants to fall in love with this great author. Great story from a great author about his journey around America in a truck hauling a camper, and with his beloved dog. If you haven't read this Steinbeck book yet, well, it's time you did. A charming account of the author's travels across America in his funky vehicle with his standard-sized black poodle named Charlie. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.